Hello my dear students, good morning one and all. In today's lecture of maths, we are going to learn addition and subtraction of irrational numbers. Okay. Before starting this concept, let me introduce you with some useful identities which are required in many ways while doing the addition, subtraction, multiplication and division of the irrational numbers. Okay. So see, first is identity is square root of a bracket square. Okay. So before that, let me tell you about this sign. What is name of this sign? Do you know? Or the name of this sign? Only this sign when there is no a number written here. It's called radical sign. Radical sign. Okay. This is called radical sign, and when any number is written or it's written here, it may be 2 or 3 or 4, right? N number. Okay. So when its order is 2, that time it is called square root. Okay. When its order is 3, at that time it's called cube root. Similarly, if order is 4, then 4th root, 5th root, 6th root, likewise n root. Okay. The number inside this, it should be always greater than 0, and the number which is written here means its order, it should be positive integers in this arrangement. The number inside the radical sign, it should be greater than 0, and the number which is its order, it should be positive integer. And when there is square root, listen here carefully, when there is square root means its order is 2, at that time you do not write that, it is written simply this. Okay, when that means when any order is not written here, consider that it is a square root. If it is more than 2, means 3, 4, then that number will be written here. Third root, that is called cube root, then fourth root, fifth root, sixth root. Understood? So see here, first identity, it is all these identities which I have written here, they are related with the square root. Okay. So first identity is square root of a bracket square. So in this case, how this can be written? See, suppose we have square root of 2 into square root of 2. Okay, so what we do? Square root of 2 into 2, that is square root of 4. And you know that square root of 4, 4 is square number, it is square of 2. That's why its square is square root of 4 is 2. Understood? Means square root of 2 into square root of 2 means square of square root of 2. Is this arrangement? That means if there is any number other than 2, means square root of a is bracket square, if it is like this, then what answer we are getting? The number which is inside it, that is a itself. Okay? Square root of a, square of square root of a is a. Okay? Then square root of a into b, this can be written as square root of a into square root of b. Similarly, square root of a upon b, this can be written as square root of a upon square root of b. Okay? Now see this. In the first bracket, square root of a plus square root of b into square root of a minus square root of b. Can you tell me, Have you ever studied about this identity in the earlier classes? See, it is actually a plus b, a minus b into a minus b. That is, how do we write that? A square minus b square. Okay, similarly here, if it is like this, root of a plus square root of b, and square root of a minus square root of b, then its expansion will be square root of a bracket square minus square root of b bracket square. And when there is bracket square root of a, what we have got? A, correct? So here we get a minus here b. Okay, so here a minus b simply. When there is in the first bracket square root of a plus square root of b into square root of a minus square root of b. So its answer is a minus b. Okay, here a plus square root of b in the first bracket into second bracket a minus square root of b. So in this case what will be there? Here both the terms were in the square root, but here a is not in the square root, only b is square root. That's why a square minus square root of b will be b. A square minus b. Okay. In the first bracket, square root of a plus square root of b into, in the second bracket, square root of c plus square root of b. This is simply just a multiplication, square root of a into c, square root of c plus square root of a into d plus square root of b into c plus square root of b into d. Okay? After that, see the last one, square root of a plus square root of b bracket square. So this identity, which is this identity, a plus b bracket square, a square is equal to a square plus 2ab plus b square. So here, root a plus root b bracket square is equal to root a square plus 2 into root a into root b plus root b square. Correct? That is, root a square means a plus 2 into root a into root b, that is under root of ab, plus root b square means simply b. So we have a plus 2 into root ab plus b square. Okay, so write down these identities in your notebook, recite them. These identities are useful while doing the addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. So recite them properly, understand them and then recite, okay? Now let us see about the addition and subtraction of the irrational numbers, okay? Dear students, you know that in previous class we have learned the addition, subtraction of rational numbers, and we have seen that rational numbers satisfy the commutative, associative and distributive laws for the addition and multiplication. Similarly, here also irrational numbers satisfy the commutative, distributive and associative laws for the addition and multiplication. Then we have seen that rational numbers are close under addition, subtraction, multiplication and even in division except 0. Means if we add, subtract, multiply or divide the rational numbers, we get answer as a rational number. Only there is exception of 0 in the division. But here in the addition and subtraction of irrational numbers or operation on irrational numbers, we found that, for example, in the case C, root 6 plus minus root 6, correct? So that means we get here root 6 minus root 6, and this will be cancelled, we will get 0, and 0 is not irrational number, it is rational number. Okay. Similarly, in the multiplication, root 6 into root 6, its answer is 6, which is rational number. Okay. So, see here, root 6 divided by root 6, it will be cancelled, its answer will be 1, which is rational number. So, or we can say that irrational numbers are not closed under the addition, subtraction, multiplication or division. Okay. Another point is that what happens when we do the operation with rational and irrational numbers. Let us see here, if we add 3 plus root 2 or 3 multiplied by root 2, what will happen? Okay, so actually this addition will be itself 3 plus root 2, and since root 2 is irrational number, Since root 2 is irrational number, so this number together 3 plus root 2, it is also an irrational number. Similarly here, 3 multiplied by root 2, its answer is 3 root 2. And since root 2 is irrational number, that's why its product is also an irrational number. Okay, so this 3 plus root 2 and 3 root 2, these are irrational numbers. So any rational number, when it is operated with the irrational numbers, the answer which we get, it is also an irrational number. Okay, so these are some facts about the additions operations on the rational number. Let us see now how to do the addition and subtraction of irrational numbers. Okay, see here I have written some examples here which are examples of addition and subtraction of irrational numbers. So see the basic rule when we can do the addition and subtraction of irrational numbers. See here I have written some irrational numbers: 4 root 2, 6 root 2, 3 root 2 and 7 root 2. Here if you observe these 4 irrational numbers, this irrational factor is same in all, among all 4, in all 4, okay, that is root 2, root 2, root 2, root 2. So these 4 irrational numbers are said to be like irrational numbers, because their irrational factor is same, that is root 2, like irrational numbers, okay. And here in the second, 4 root 3, 3 root 2, 4 root 5, 9 root 7, here if you observe this irrational factor, they are not same. That's why such irrational numbers are said to be unlike, okay, unlike irrational numbers. Unlike irrational numbers. Understood? So, the principle of addition and subtraction is we can add or subtract only the like irrational numbers. Like in fraction we have seen, we can add or subtract only like fraction. Similarly here, we can add or subtract only the like irrational numbers whose irrational factor is same. And in case if irrational factors is not same, that means if they are not like irrational numbers, then we have to make them and then we have to add. Okay, so we are going to see while solving those examples. So pay attention very carefully. See, first example is 3 root 2 plus 5 root 2. Now if you will see, since they are like irrational numbers, because the irrational factor is root 2, root 2, means they are like real irrational numbers, that's why we can add them. Now see how to add. What to do? Here 3 root 2 plus 3 root 2. Root 2, root 2 is same in both the terms. That's why that will be taken common in bracket, remaining here 3 plus 5. Which law we have used here? Distributive law. Okay? So this root 2 which was common, we have taken it out and in bracket remain 3 plus 5. So it's root 2, here 3 plus 5, 8. That's why it can be written as 8 root 2. Okay? Then see second one. Second one is 2 root 2 plus 5 root 3 plus, in another bracket there is root 2 minus 3 root 3. Now how to do the addition here? If you see first bracket, here root 2 root 2 and 5 plus 5 root 3. These two irrational numbers are not like, here same in the second bracket, here root 2 and here root 3, that's they are also not like. But by using associative law, we will change their combination. We can do that, right? As we have seen that irrational numbers follows the rules of association for the addition or multiplication. That's why we can see here, we can associate them. So 2 root 2 will be associated with this 2 root 2, root 2 plus 5 root 3 and minus minus 3 root 3. Correct? Because they are now like irrational numbers. Okay. Now see here. In this bracket, root 2 is common, that's why we can add their coefficient. That is, root 2 we will take common in bracket 2 plus 1 plus, similarly here root 3 will be taken out, remain 5 minus 3. Okay, here see, before this there is no any number, that's why here 1. Okay, no any number means there is 1. So here root 2, 2 plus 1, 3. Plus root 3, here 5 minus 3, 2. So the answer is 3 root 2 plus 2 root 3. Okay? Understood? See third one. Third one example is 8 root 3. Minus 2 root 3 plus 4 root 3. Now check, are they like irrational numbers? See, the irrational factor is root 3, here also root 3, here also root 3. Three terms are there, okay? And we have seen that the irrational factor is same, that's why they are irrational, like irrational numbers. So hence, we can add them, add or subtract them, okay? So in all the three terms, what is common? Root 3, that will take out, and in the bracket remains here 8 minus 2 plus 4. So root 3 in bracket, 8 minus 2, 6, 6 plus 4, 10. That's why 10 root 3 is the answer. Okay? Next, our first write these three examples. Afterwards, we will see next examples. See here, example number 4. Example number D. Okay, 4 root 2 plus 3 root 32. Now, see here, if you observe, the irrational factors are not same, not equal. That's why this is not like irrational, these are not like irrational numbers. So, in this case, when the irrational numbers are not like, not similar, at that time what we have to do, we have to convert them into simplest form, lowest term, as we have done in the fraction, we converted fraction into lowest term. Similarly here, we can convert the irrational number into simplest or lowest term. So how to convert that? See here, 2 is actually already in the lowest term, simplest form. This root 2, okay? Just we need to convert 32, root 32 into the lowest term. So for that, what we have to do, you know, let us take it here. 3 root 32 is equal to, we have to find here factors of 32 in such a way that one factor should be square number. Why square number? Because this radical sign is of square. Means it is square root. That's why square number. In case if it is cube root, then we need to find the factor of 32 which is cube. Okay? So here, as this is square root, we have to factorize 32 in such a way that one number should be square. And we know that 32 means what? 16 twos are. Why I have taken 16 twos are only? It is 8 fours are also 32. Okay, but I have taken 16 twos are because 16 is the square number. 8 fours are, in that 4 also square number, but it is not the simplest, not the lowest. We will not get the lowest. Means here the number inside which will remain here, we will not get the lowest. That's why directly we have taken 16 twos are. Okay? So, you know that 16 is the square of 4. 16 is the square of 4 into 2. Now this 4 square, that means cube root of 16 is 4. Square root of 16 is 4. That 4 can be taken out. We know that square a under root a square is equal to a, that is bracket square or square, it is same a. Similarly here, if it is 4 square under root, what will get answer? 4. And that 4 can be taken out with the 3. And in the bracket remains 2. Sorry, in the root, under root remains 2. See here. That's why this 4 can be taken out and it will be multiplied with the 3. And under root remain these 2. So that is 3 4s are 12, under root 2. Now this and our second irrational number, we have, when we convert it into simplest form, we have got 12 under root 2. And here irrational factor is root 2. Here also irrational factor is root 2. That's why now they have become like irrational number. That's why see. So 4 root 2 plus 12 root 2 is equal to this root 2 root 2, let's say common, but in bracket remain 4 plus 12, that is root 2 in bracket 16, which is 16 root 2. Understood what we have done? Once again I repeat, these two irrational numbers which are given there for the addition, they are not like irrational numbers. That's why one of the irrational numbers we have converted into simplest form, and we have got 12 root 2 as a simplest form of this. Okay. See next example. One by 2 under root 486 minus under root 27 upon 2. Now see this example. Here also there is subtraction of irrational numbers, but these two irrational numbers are not like. Okay, they are unlike. That's why we cannot subtract directly. Here we need to convert them into the simplest form. And as it is square root, so how to convert? Let's take one by one number. Let's take this number 1 by 2 under root 486. So under root there is 486. Now to convert them into simplest form, what we have to do? We have to factorize 486 in such a way that one number should be square number. Now if you factorize 486, we know that 486 means 81 into 6. If you don't know directly, you can factorize 486. You will get, okay? See here, this is square number 81 and 3 to the 6. So 81 6 are 486. Okay? Why 81 6 are? Because 81 is square number. 9 9s are 81. Okay? So 1 by 2 under root 81, 486 is factorized in this way, 81 into 6. So 1 by 2 under root 81 is square of 9 square into 6. And since under root a square is equal to a, that's why under root 9 square means 9. That can be taken out and it will be multiplied with the 1 by 2, which is equal to 9 1's are 9 upon 2 under root 6. Okay. Now let us simplify this. Find the simplest form of 27 under root 27 upon 2. See here. Here in the first irrational number, we have found here irrational factor, that is root 6. So what we have to do in the second irrational number also, we have to try to find the irrational factor which is equal to this root 6. Okay, so see now we have 27. Let us factorize 27. You know 27, if you factorize in which the one number should be square, you will get 9 threes are, because 9 is square number. Okay, so it can be written this way, 9 into 3. 9 threes are upon 2. Actually, we cannot factorize. Now see, 9 is square of 3. So 3 square into 3 upon 2. So this 3 square means under root 3 square means 3. That will be taken out. Here remain 3 upon 2. Okay. Now see, here when we simplify or when we converted this into simplest form, 27 upon 2, we got 3 under root 3 upon 2. But in the first irrational number, we have found irrational factor as a root 6. So here also we want that. For that, what we need to do? This upon 2, no, we need to take out. But directly we cannot take it out of the square root sign. For that, what we need to do, you know, this 2 we need to convert into square number. Okay? So to convert that into square number, we will multiply this by 2, because 2 2s are 4, 4 is the square number. So since we have multiplied denominator by 2, we need to multiply numerator also by 2. So what we have got here? 3 under root, 3 2s are 6 upon 4. Okay. Now see, 3 under root 6 upon, this 4 is square number of 2. 2 square, and you know 2 square means here actually 1 by 2 square. So 3, this 1 by 2 under root of 1 by 2 square, it will come out. At that time it will become 1 by 2 simply. Okay, so it will be multiplied with the 3 and under root remain this 6. Understood what we have done here? See, 6 upon under root 6 upon 4. And you know 4 is square number of 2, that is 2 square. So this 2 square means under root 2 square means 2. That came out, and 2 is in the denominator, that's the 1 by 2. Okay. So here 3 1 are 3 upon 2 under root 6. But now another irrational number with the same irrational factor. Now both the irrational numbers are like, now we can do the operation over there. So they see 9 upon 2 under root 6 minus 3 upon 2 under root 6 is equal to 6 is common, under root 6 is common, that take out, in bracket remain 9 upon 2 minus 3 upon 2, that is under root 6. Denominators are same, subtract numerator, 9 minus 3, 6 upon 2. 2 1s are 2, 2 3s are 6. So answer is 3 under root 6. Here we got 3, that we have written here, and under root 6. 3 under root 6 is the answer. Understood? Once again, write these two examples in your notebook. See here, next one example, example number 4, F, 4 root 2 minus 2 root 8. Plus 3 upon root 2. Okay. See, all the 3 irrational numbers are not like. So first we need to convert them into simplest form. First one is already in the simplest forms. Let us take second one here. 2 root 8. And how 8 can be factorized, in which one number should be square? See, you know that 8 means 4 2s are, in which 4 is square number. So this root 2 can be written as, so root 8 can be written as 4 into 2. It is 2 under root. 4 is square of 2. 2 square into 2. So this 2 square will be taken out, that will be 2 square. Under root 2 square means 2. It will be taken out and it will be multiplied with this 2. Under root remain these two. Okay. So 2 2s are 4 root 2. This is second one we got. First one already is there with the root 2. See third one. 3 upon root 2. Here there is root 2, but it is in the denominator. That's why it is not lying with this. Okay. What we have to do? We need to get the root 2 in the numerator. We need to get the root 2 in the numerator, and this root 2 should be taken out. Okay. Now see, what for that what we can do, this root 2, to bring these two out of the square root sign, what we need to do, we need to multiply this root 2 by root 2. So since we have multiplied the denominator, in the numerator also we need to multiply by root 2. So we will get here 3 into root 2, 3 root 2, and root 2 into root 2, that is root 2 square means 2 itself. Okay, so the root 2 into root 2 becomes 2, the first identity which we have seen. So this number we have got 3 upon 2 root 2, third one. Okay, now we have all three numbers with the irrational factor as a root 2. Now we can do the operation over there. Let us do it. 4 root 2 minus 4 root 2 plus 3 by 2 root 2. Now see, this plus 4 root 2 minus 4 root 2, it will be cut 0. What remains simply? 3 by 2 root 2 is your answer. Okay? Next, example number G, last one. Under root 48 minus root 72, square root of 72 minus 27, under root 27 plus 2 under root 18. Four terms are there. Now see here. All are not irrational, like irrational numbers, that's why we need to find the simplest form of them. And since they are under square root, that's why we have to factorize them in such a way that one number should be square. So we know that in the factors of 48, we have 16 threes are, correct? 16 threes are 48. Let us take separate one by one. This under root of 48 can be factorized in this way. 16 threes are. Why 16 threes are? Because 16 is a square number, that's why. So it is under root. 16 is a square of 4. That's why 4 square into 3. And this under root of 4 square will be taken out. It will become 4 under root 3. Okay? This is first irrational number. Second, under root of 72. So 72 can be factorized in such a way that, see, 72 means 36 twos are, because 36 is the square number. 36 twos are. So 36 is the square of 6. That's why 6 square into 2, which is equal to 6. Under root of 6 square will be taken out. It will remain 6. It is 6 under root 2. See here, we are not getting same irrational factors. Then also see what happens. Under root 27, and it can be factorized in such a way that one number should be square number, and we know that 27 is 9 threes are. So 9 is the square number of square of 3, 3 square into this 3. So 3 square, under root 3 square is equal to 3, and under root remain this 3. Okay. And last one, 2 root 18. So here we have to factorize 18. We know 18 means 9 twos are 18, correct? And because 9 square numbers, 9 twos are 18. That's why 2 under root, 9 square of 3. 3 square into 2. This 3 square, under root of 3 square means 3. That will be taken out and multiplied with the 2. Under root remain these 2. So 3 2s are 6. Under root 2. So these 4 irrational numbers we have got, simplest form of those 4 irrational numbers we have found, and in that here root 3 and here root 3, here root 2 and here root 2. So two terms we are getting like. Let's do the operation over them. I'm taking from here. Minus 40, for under root 48, that means 4 under root 3 minus here 6 under root 2 minus 3 under root 3 plus 6 under root 2. Now see here, minus 6 under root 2 and plus 6 under root 2, these are two like irrational numbers, and as they are opposite of each other, they can be cut. Okay, 0. 4 under root 3 minus 3 under root 3. Here minus 3 under root 3 is common, that's why it will be taken out in bracket 4 minus 3. So is equal to under root 3. 4 minus 3, 1. Correct? That is, so the final answer is under root 3 itself. When one is coefficient, we don't write that. So the answer is under root 3. Okay? So in this way, we can add or subtract the irrational numbers. Remember that we can add or subtract only the like irrational numbers, and if they are not like, we have to make convert them into simplest form, and we have to make them like. Understood? And how to convert them into simplest form, that we have seen. As this is square root, so factorize the given number in such a way that one number should be square. If it is cube root, instead of your square, if it is cube root, if it is given like this, cube root of 3, cube root of 81, then while factorizing or while converting it into simplest forms, what we have to do, we have to factorize 81 in such a way that one number should be cube. And you know that 27 threes are 81, and here why I have taken 27, because 27 is a cube, so it will be 3 cube into 3. So 3 cube, cube root of 3 cube will be 3, that will be taken out, here remain 3, it will be like this. Okay, so when there is cube root, while factorizing, while converting into simplest form, and while for that, while factorizing, take one number as a cube. Okay, if there is fourth root, then you have to take fourth power of any number. Okay, so in this way we can add or subtract the irrational numbers. If you have any doubt in this, you can ask me. Some examples I am going to give for the extra work that you have to solve in the extra notebook, not regular notebook. Understood? So thank you for today. Have a nice day.